have some slides that I prepared, but I'm actually probably not going to use them because I had a different script prepared for tonight, but given the recent events that have happened, I decided to toss it and use my time differently tonight. I decided to speak less about me and more about us, because I think that we have a platform like this. You should use it in as positive a manner as you can. So I do want to speak a little bit about my first slide, because this is a personal motto of mine. Speak your truth, live your truth. I spoke a little bit about that in my vision stand back in January. For those of our guests here, I announced that I was leaving my 12-year career as a lawyer to quit my job and go off on my own and start my own business.
What?
That would be my husband. Surprise! No, he knows. Anyway, so that's the very short version. I can tell you all my story later at the bar if you want to hear it. But given recent events, again, I think it's more important to focus on our story versus my story. So shortly after what happened in Orlando, I posted something on Facebook, which I'll read to you because it sort of frames the discussion that we're going to have. But getting back to my motto about speak your truth, live your truth, that just basically means that I believe we all have our own personal truths, and those are our core values by which we live, and those are things that we truly believe. And when we don't live in alignment with those personal truths, our lives can get out of whack. And I think that's true in groups and in the world. And I think that right now, our world is a little bit out of whack. And when our world is out of whack, things like what happened in Orlando start to happen, and they keep happening. So this is what I posted on Facebook the other day, and I'll explain it a little bit more as we go along. I remain resolute in my belief during these trying times that there is far more light in the world than there is dark. The voices of the light may be softer and gentler, but they are stronger and will overcome in the end, even when, at times like this, it may not seem so. The fact that we can all pull together across countries, religions, races, genders, orientations, and all manner of other differences is what will defeat darkness in the end. As I was reflecting on what I wanted to say here today, it hit me that this program and all of my Bridge Builders classmates out there exemplify the light. Because we've done it. 9 months ago, we all came here, and let's face it, the majority of us were stuck in a rut. We'd all been in the same job for X number of years, been hanging out with the same people, going to the same places, doing the same thing. And as Danielle pointed out, we were thrown into a room with 65 strangers, thinking, what the hell, you know, have I gotten myself into? We were continually forced out of our comfort zones, forced to open up to people we weren't so sure about, maybe weren't comfortable with. We were forced to be vulnerable, to share our most intimate thoughts and feelings. We shared tragedy together, we shared babies, we shared marriages, but we did it. We reached across all of those divides, built bridges. We are the light. And that's what this program has proved to me, is that there really is more light than there is dark. And even though at times the dark voices seem louder, it's only because they're harsher and more dissonant. But our voices, the voices of the light, will win it in the end, because our voices work together to build a harmony. And we will conquer the dark in the end. And we build bridges, just as the name of the program states. And we build bridges just not just in the civic realm, as we have learned for the past 9 months, and not just as we've done, but we've also learned to build bridges across humanity, across the divides of humanity. So let's keep doing it, even after this program ends. Let's keep reaching across those divides, keep reaching out to one another, to those of us who are different, those of us who need a helping hand. That's our truth. That's the truth we need to speak. That's the truth we need to live. So let's keep doing it. Thank you.